Thank you guys for watching our videos. Here is the part 2 of the tutorial on how to make computer run faster. Keep watching.
MCCS, transforming experience, presenting opportunities.
Tip number 5. Run defragmentation tool. It helps you to arrange the files in folders and optimize the Windows performance. Run defragmentation tool, no matter you use solid state drive or traditional disk hard drive. How often do you need to run defragmentation tool? Do it on a monthly basis. How to run the defragmentation tool to speed up the system storage? Use these steps. Simply write the word defragment on the start search and choose defragment and optimized drive. Click on it and you will see this window. To defragment and optimize each drive, you can click and choose the drive you want. You simply click on optimize. First it analyzes, then it starts defragmenting. It takes time, you have to wait and finish it. Once you finish it, then restart the computer. Tip number 6. Restart your PC regularly. This tip is simple. Restarting closes all the software running on your PC. Not only the programs you see running on the taskbar, but also dozens of services that might have been started by the various programs and never stopped. Restarting can fix mysterious performance problems when the exact cause is hard to pinpoint. Restarting a PC is a good way to clear out its memory and ensure that any errant processes and services that started running get shut down. If you keep so many programs, email messages, and websites open that you think restarting is a hassle, that is probably a sign you should restart your PC. The more things you have opened and the longer you keep them running, the greater the chances your PC will bog down and eventually run low on memory. How often should you restart your computer? Restart your PC at least once a week. Restart your PC when you install an application, update apps, update Windows and EDC. Restart your PC when you feel you need to restart. Tip number 7. Disable programs on startup. Warning. Do not disable programs which are published by Microsoft Corporation, and also do not disable the antivirus if you have any. Where is the list of programs on a startup? The list is in the Windows Task Manager. How can we disable them? To see and disable them, you can have 4 ways. 1. Windows settings. 2. Use the shortcut Control or Delete. 3. Use the shortcut Ctrl Shift Space and right click on the hidden icons tray and select Task Manager. Now let's do it practically. Start, Settings. Here you click on Apps. Once you are here, on the left pane, you see there is Startup. Click on Startup. This is the list of the apps which start up along with the Windows. You can disable them by using the turn on and turn off button, or you right click on hidden icon and choose task manager. In here on app there is startup tab. When you click on the startup tab, you can disable any app that you want from here. These are the apps that you have to disable them when you do not need them. But be careful, you see here this is written Microsoft Corporation, Windows Security Notifications. It should not be disabled from here. Leave it as it is. So I disable this one. Yeah, this is also Microsoft Corporation, Microsoft OneDrive. Leave it as it is. It should be enabled. I disable the Skype Decorer. From here, I can disable it. That's it, guys. Just disable all those apps which are not in use. Tip number 8. Disk cleanup. You can use disk cleanup on a regular basis to reduce the number of unnecessary files on your drives, which can free up drive space and help your PC run better. It can delete temporary files and system files, empty the recycle bin, and remove a variety of other items that you might no longer need. How often should you do it? You can do it on a monthly basis or anytime you need it. Should you do a disk cleanup for C drive only? No, it is recommended doing for all drive partitions. Okay, now let's do it practically. Go to Start Search, write disk cleanup. Select the top result. Here you will see a small disk cleanup drive selection window. From here you can select the drives C, D, and F. So now for now I select C and I click on OK. Now it is calculating. It takes a little time. Once you are here on the disk cleanup for C drive or any other drive, you can put a check mark on all these boxes and select them. Then you come down and click on OK. Here it warns you, are you sure you want to permanently delete these files? Click on delete files. Now the disk cleanup utility is cleaning up unnecessary files on your machine. If you see here, cleaning Windows update cleanup, it means some Windows updates are installed in your computer which are not needed anymore. So this tool will help you to clean up those Windows updates too. Okay, C drive cleanup is done. Up to now we are done with the C drive. Let's also do a disk cleanup on D and F drive too. Go to Start Search, disk cleanup. This time I choose D drive, click on OK. Here we have two things, the recycle bin and the DirectX shared cache. Just click on OK. Click on delete files. Okay, it's done. Let's go to the next drive. Search disk, disk cleanup. This time I choose F drive. Click on OK. Click on OK again. Click on delete files. Okay guys, it's all done with the disk cleanup. It is time to restart your computer. First you have to close all your open files, then restart your computer. After that you will be done. Tip number 9, delete the Windows temp files. What are the Windows temp files? Windows temporary files are created by the Windows services or operating system during the normal course of its running when there may not be enough memory allocated for the task. If you delete Windows temporary files, you free up more storage space for your hard drive to make your computer run faster. How to delete the Windows temp files for best results? For best results, make sure all windows and programs are closed before proceeding. How often should you delete the temp files? It depends on the drive storage. For drive with more space, it is recommended to delete them on a monthly basis. Otherwise, you can delete them on a weekly basis. How can we delete them? For Windows temp files, you go to search, type run, enter, you write temp, temp, enter. The Windows temporary files folder is opened. Yet to select them all, use Ctrl A, right click, and delete them all. Click on yes, put a check mark, and then click on escape. And close the folder. After deleting the temporary files, you make sure to delete them also from the recycle bin because they are sent to the recycle bin. You right click on recycle bin and choose empty recycle bin. Click on yes. Now restart your computer. Then you are done. Tip number 10. Delete the local or user's temp files. What are the local or user's temp files? These files are the temporary files like internet history, cookies, and caches take up a ton of space on your hard disk. So deleting them is safe and frees up valuable space on your hard disk and speeds up your computer. How to delete the local or user's temp files for best results? For best results, make sure all windows and programs are closed before proceeding. How often should you delete the temp files? It depends on the drive storage. For drive with more space, it is recommended to delete them on a monthly basis. Otherwise, you can delete them on a weekly basis. How can we delete them? Go to Start Search and type Run. Either you click on the top result or press Enter. Write %TEMP%Enter. You will see this temporary files folder. Select all of them by Control A. Right click and delete. Click on Yes. Here it shows that there are some files which are open and cannot be deleted. So you put a check mark on Do this for all current items and then click on Escape. This is just because of the files are opened. It is done. Close the folder. Now once again you have to empty the recycle bin. Right click and choose empty recycle bin. Click on Yes and reinstall your computer. Okay, it is all done for today. Guys, if you still didn't watch the part 1 of this video, you can simply write MCCS Consultancy, click on the channel of MCCS, click on video, scroll down and watch the part 1 of this video. And good luck, guys.